Good morning and Jai Hind. Today in this video, we are going to learn about the third chapter in our book, that is Accounting Principles. So let us start the video. Accounting Principles. Let us read what it is written here. The general guidelines or set of rules usually called generally accepted accounting principles used for preparing the accounting statements. So from this we can conclude that there are few set of rules or principles or guidelines which are prescribed by all the accountants, which is universally accepted for preparing our accounting statements. So these are known as the accounting principles. And these accounting principles are generally accepted by the accountants all over the world. That means there is complete uniformity among all the accounting statements prepared in all over the world. Next is characteristics of accounting principles. There are four main characteristics of accounting principles. The first one is uniform set of rules. That means uniform set of rules or guidelines are developed to ensure the uniformity among all the accounting statements, so that it can be easily understandable. Okay, so to maintain the uniformity, there are a specific set of rules prescribed. Second is man-made. Accounting principles are man-made, which are derived after the experience and various other reasons of many accountants from very long time, from the past onwards. Okay, these are man-made. These are not scientific. Okay, these are not tested in a laboratory. They are, these principles are man-made. Next is flexible. These accounting principles are not rigid. They are very, very much flexible. And they used to changes as that need requires. As there's some need arises, in that case, these principles may change. There is very much flexibility in these principles. And the last one is generally accepted. As I have just said that these principles are accepted by all in the whole world, by all the accountants. And these helps in preparing our accounting statements, our accounting records. And this is done on the three criteria. Well, first is relevant. That means the information which we are presenting should be quite relevant in preparing our accounting statements. Second is objectivity. Okay, the information which we are presenting should be free from personal bias or judgment. And the last one is feasibility. That means how much it is feasible. That means there should be no complexity or minimum cost. The unnecessary cost should be avoided. All three criteria are very important while accepting these principles all over the world. Okay. Next is need of accounting principles. Then after why we are doing all such complex practice of accounting the statement of preparing the accounting statements, it's very important for us to know the reason or why we need this. So the basic need of preparing the accounting statements by following these accounting principles is that it helps us in comparing the performance of a company by other firms as well as by its own performance with the previous year performance. Okay, that means whenever we prepare our financial statements using the accounting principles, then we can easily compare our firm's performance with some other firm performance also, as both firms are using the same principles, and it becomes easy for us as there's a uniformity. That means we can easily understand both the accounting statements, as they are uniform in nature, they are following the same principles, and similarly we can compare our own performance, our current own performance with the performance of the previous year of our own firm. Okay, basically that means the comparison is the basic need. We can compare the performance of the of our firm. So this is why we need to be uniform in our financial statements. Kinds of accounting principles. See, there are two kinds of accounting principles. First is accounting concepts or assumptions, and second is accounting conventions. So let's study about them one by one. Accounting concepts or assumptions. Accounting concepts. See, these are the concepts or which number of accountants have agreed, and these are usually followed by preparing the financial statements. These concepts guide how transactions should be recorded or reported. In this, three main accounting concepts are given: going concern concept, consistency concept, and accrual concept. Going concern concept. In this concept, we assume that business will continue to exist for a long period in future. It is a never-ending process. If we start a business, we assume that our business will run for the infinite period of time. We are not going to stop our business in future. That's the basic assumption each firm before starting its own business used to assume that our firm will never stop working. It will remain for infinity, for infinite time. It will always be for long period of time. It will run for long period of time. Next is consistency concept. In this concept, that accounting principles and methods should remain consistent from one year to another. That means we can't change our accounting principles in the first year or maybe in the second year. We can't change that. We have to stick to the same accounting principles. We have to be consistent whenever we make our accounting statements. In each and every year, the same principles should be followed. We can't change. We can't switch to some other principles. Okay? Next is our accrual concept. Accrual concept says that when we make any transaction, whether the actual cash receipt or payment happens or not, it doesn't matter. The main thing matters is that whether the sale has been occurred or whether purchase has been occurred or not. At that time, at the accrual, that's the accrual period. When we enter that transaction in our account statements, we don't wait for that period when the actual recovery of the sale or actual payment of the purchase is made in cash terms. We don't bother about that. We just note that transaction at that time whenever the sale happens. It may be on credit also. Okay. And whenever we purchase some raw material or goods in credit, it doesn't matter whether we make the payment in cash at that moment or not. Okay. Or whether we get the receipt of the receipt of the sale at that moment or not. It doesn't matter. It may happen in future. Okay. But whenever on books, it will be recorded whenever the sale is done on credit basis. At that moment only, we have to record that transaction as a sale or purchase of goods. Okay. A few more concepts are given, which we are going to discuss in our next video. Thank you.